Having lots of expensive sensors and a really impressive logging package isn't going to do you much good if you don't have the configuration of your logger set up properly. Today I'm going to go through three of the most common problems I see in the way people set up their loggers and show you guys the right way to do it. I'm going to be using a MoTeC logger for this demonstration, but these concepts are going to be applicable regardless of the system you're using. The first aspect of a logger configuration I want to go through today is the start and stopping logging condition. Now this is one of the most critical things to get right in the configuration of your logger because it's obviously controlling what will and won't be recorded when you're doing your logging. We've often got lots of options and lots of different logic that we can choose from when we're going through to decide how we're going to both start and stop the logging. So let's jump across to my laptop screen and have a look at an example. So for a start, at the top here, we've got the conditions that need to be met for the logging to start. And at the bottom, we've got the conditions for the logging to stop. Now, for a start with here, it's really simple. It's just saying when the engine speed is greater than 2000 RPM, the logger is going to start recording a log file. Then once the engine speed has been at zero for 10 seconds or greater, the logger will then stop recording. It's easy to see how critical it is to get these settings set correctly inside of your logger. Now, obviously at one end of the spectrum, if your start condition isn't correct or isn't going to be triggered by something when your car goes on track, then you're never going to actually record any of the log data. At the other end of the spectrum, if your stop condition isn't right, you may end up with log files that are way too big if you're getting a whole lot of useless data at the end of the run that you don't actually care about. Now, that's a big problem because all loggers have a finite amount of storage in them, and depending on how many channels you're logging, your log files may get so big that your logger will be full and it may end up filling up before you've even completed all the data that you want together. So I just want to give an example of how we might increase the level of sophistication on a logging setup like this. So over here, we've got the option here. We can see when I click next to the engine speed, it brings up this prompt to say and that's saying that we've got the option to add another condition in there. So for something else to be true. So let's go with the example of if we want the engine speed to be above a certain value, but we also want the road speed to be above a certain value. Now there's lots of situations where we might have the engine running, but we might not want to record the log data. Let's say you're doing engine tests or you're doing some engine tuning or whatever it is in the pit lane. In this situation, with any time the engine speed is above 2000 RPM, we're going to start recording a log file. So what I'm going to do in this situation is add a condition that the vehicle must also be moving as well. And that's going to mean that both the condition of engine speed above 2000 and the vehicle must be moving are both going to need to be met before the log file starts recording. So let's add that in now. So I'm going to use the channel called a ground speed here. So if I add that in here, so this is saying the value of ground speed, we've got some options here to choose greater than, less than, equal to. I'm going to say greater than or equal to 10 kilometers an hour. And I'm going to say that needs to be true for 2 seconds for that to be true. So if we add that in here, now this channel reads engine speed greater than 2000 RPM and ground speed greater than 10 kilometers an hour for 2 seconds. And that's when our log file will start recording. As far as that stopping condition goes, that's going to depend on the type of racing you're doing and how you want to break up your log files. So let's say you're doing something like endurance racing where you're doing many pit stops within a race. So depending on how you want to break up those log files, you may want to tie it to road speed, you may want to tie it to engine speed, and that's also obviously going to depend whether the engine's going to switch off or not during the pit stops. You can see how your different situation is going to depend how you're going to want to configure that stop condition as well. Another common problem I see with the way people set up their loggers is their file storage hierarchy, otherwise known as data management. So this is a really important point to get right because in many cases you are going to want to go back and look at old log data, and this might be happening a long time after you originally recorded it. Now what I mean by data management is going through and organizing everything in a structured way to make it easy to find the log files that you're looking for. Here on my laptop screen I've got one of the configuration options up here, and this is just showing how I choose to break down my log data. So in this case I'm using a MoTeC logging system. I then break it down inside the log data file. I break it down by circuit, then I break it down by year, and then I break it down by event. So that's always the same hierarchy. I always have the location or the circuit we're at, then the season, and then the event, because in many cases I might be going back to the same circuit many times within one season. The other thing I tend to do with my event folders here is to prefix them with some numbers. The reason I do that is it just helps me keep them in order because I want them to be in chronological order. Again, it just makes it easier to go back and see it in a more organized way. So within each one of these folders, this is where I've got the actual log data itself stored. Now this might seem like a really trivial thing, but I guarantee going through and spending the time to make a well-organized file structure to help with your data management will pay off in the future. The last thing I want to talk about here as far as logger configuration is adding sufficient detail when you do your data downloads. Now what I mean by that is each time you download the car, you want to be adding information to that log file so that when you go back and look at it later, it's going to give you a bit more context about what happened and what was important during that run. So here on my laptop screen, I've got an example of that. When you go through and do a download on your car, every data system will be a little bit different how it manages this as far as what the dialog boxes look like and what options it gives you to name and add details to it. But what we've got on the screen here is relatively generic and representative of most systems. So the hierarchy, the way it works here, we've got the event name where I've got some information about the car we're running, what event we're running, what year it's happening in as well. Then I've got the session. So in this case, we've been running in practice 3. The short comment, now that's something that's specific to the way Motip works, but many other logging systems will have a different, the same system but with a different name. All I use that for is a sequential download number. So every time I do a download in the car, I increment that number by one. So DL1, DL2, DL3, in this case is DL7, so this means it's the 7th download of this event. In the long comment section here, I've gone and added some information about a change we made to the car for that run. Now that's going to be really important context if we're going to want to go back and look at that log data in more detail, because if we see a difference in the data, we may be wanting to know where that came from, and this is just giving us a little bit of a pointer as to what differences we had with the car on this run. Now here I've opened up i2's analysis software, which before we were looking at the logger configuration software, now I'm looking at what the data will look like when we open it up to do the analysis itself. So here in this dialog box, we can see we've got 4 logs files stored in this event folder, and you can see we've got some information about the track that we were at. This is the event, we've got the fastest lap time summary, we've got sequential download numbers, we've got the year, and also we've got some information here about which driver was in the car, which different logging systems will give you a chance to select which driver was in the car in a slightly different way. But it is important to go through and add. If you've got more than one driver driving your car, it is really important to go through and actually update so you've got the right driver selected, because again, that's really important context if you're going back and looking at it later. So you can see on the right side down here, we've also got a little bit of context about this first download. You can see particularly the long comment for this one here. It says shakedown after oil pressure sensor wiring repaired. So we had a problem with some wiring with an oil pressure sensor, and this is just a note to say that this is the first run after repairing that sensor. So those are 3 common problems I see in the way people set up their loggers. I think you can see from going through those examples how critical it is to get some of those details right in order to have well-structured data that you can make use of later. All of the examples I've gone through today, as well as a whole lot more detail, are all included in our Data Analysis Fundamentals and our Professional Motorsport Data Analysis courses. If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you subscribe. We're constantly releasing new videos, and if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description of this video to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.